And the government's dirty little secret is it rigged, I believe, is killing the middle class. Inflation is not over. The Fed will continue to tighten. I'm not entirely sure this is priced into the markets. Hello, this is Nathan. Welcome back to Independence Money. Today's topic is a little spicy, so I'm giving that disclosure up front. And it's about inflation and the government's dirty little secret. Is it rigged? Is the data that they're giving us that, hey, we're actually winning the war on inflation, it's actually coming down, is that factually, mathematically correct? Or does it fall under the category of cooked books? Let's get into it. So the White House or Bidenomics is claiming that we're winning the war on inflation. Inflation is lower than expected, but it's still increasing. It's just increasing a little slower. But this is the official CPI, which is the Consumer Price Index, or in English, inflation. The problem with it is it doesn't include, or more specifically, it excludes two major costs, which are housing and energy. Well, that is the two largest expenditures that most Americans pay, with the exception of maybe groceries, which travels via energy to the grocery store from its point of origin. So I think the most Americans, or at least the ones that do their own shopping at the grocery store or pump their own gas, are probably realizing that inflation is not over and things are beginning to cost more and more, and you're getting less and less for what you put in your grocery cart. So let's get into this. So CPI goes back to something like 1917 or 1913, and it basically values the increase of goods and services. But I'm a big stickler using the correct words. And what that really means in English is the dollar is losing purchasing power because of the mismanagement of the money supply. And so let's get into that. So CPI began officially being books were being cooked in 1983, which was a period of rampant inflation. And so the US Bureau of Labor and Statistics started to rig the calculation to curb inflation so they didn't have to give as much raises on federal pensions and Social Security, because those are driven by, quote, the official CPI. So if you want to save a little money, you just rig the official CPI. So 1983 was when that happened. And this causes a ramification of problems. So inflation really drives a lot of citizens towards government programs and entitlements to bail them out. This naturally behooves the government, and it allows for them to pass key legislation, like recently the Inflation Reduction Act, which I have trouble as a math guy saying, how could a bill that's estimated to cost $1 trillion on top of the other spending that we've done is supposed to lower money? If you're going to spend more money, it by nature creates more inflation. Maybe it does some good for climate change, but just label it correctly. This is going to cause more inflation, but lower climate change. That may have been more truthful marketing. But I think the government has been a benefactor of inflation because it allows for them to pay their debt back cheaper. If the cost of their borrowing is 3 or 4% on long-term notes and inflation is running at, say, 10, they're paying it back with diluted, cheaper dollars in the future on a lower interest rate today. And if you want to get into conspiracy theories, I believe it is killing the middle class. That's not a conspiracy theory. That's facts. It's killing the middle class. The conspiracy theory is that a motivation of the government? If you look at long-range economics throughout centuries, the middle class is a bit of a modern anomaly. Before that, it was the rich and the poor, or the barons and the serfs. And that's how the majority of civilization was controlled, because there's those that have and those that have not. Middle class are objects of change, instruments of change. They can make things happen because they're not dependent on the government entitlements. More people on entitlements, more people that vote for bigger government. So let's get into some quotes here. Forbes, I'll give you the links to these below. Inflation is not over. The Fed will continue to tighten. I'm not entirely sure this is priced into the markets. I think the markets are trying to like go back to the good old fashioned bull market because the Fed might pause and soon decrease rates. Another quote from The Economist, lots of investors think inflation is under control, not so fast. Kind of backs up what I just said. And then Jason Furman, which is an economist at Harvard, says people have been crazily premature to keep declaring inflation is over. I don't think that's mathematically possible. And I'm going to get into that here in just a minute. But let me give you a couple of resources too, to really do your own due diligence. This is an educational channel after all, on what is the real inflation. Now this index here is called the Chapwood Index. You can see the link below. It measures an unfiltered basket of like 500 items that you would buy on a regular basis as an American and 50 of the largest cities in the nation. Rounding out the bottom 50 of those cities, Boston, Arlington, and Wichita coming in at 12%, dropping down to Minneapolis at 9.52 in 2022. Top three cities, big shocker here, Chicago at almost 16%, Fresno at almost 16%, and San Diego at almost 16%. I wonder what those cities' politics have in common. The second is Shadow Statistics. This has been a longstanding website that many people know about, including myself. They've been tracking the official CPI, which is saying what the government's saying, that it's a little less than 4%. But then they apply the pre-1980 calculation of CPI before the Bureau of Labor and Statistics started rigging it in 1983. They're using the government's own formula before that change in 1983, and it's saying it is still 12%. So take a look at this chart from Shadow Statistics, and it basically shows the 1980 in blue, and this chart is courtesy of Shadow Statistics, 1980 in blue, and you could see it's been running above 5, which remind you viewers, everybody's screaming about the CPI being officially in that 4-5% range. It's been really above 5 since the early 1990s. 2008, the last time we had a major financial crisis, it hit above 12% there, and it's clearly above that now, and is burning really hot since the age of easy money with artificially low interest rates and lots of government expansion. So that's something that is real and very much consistent with what you are seeing at the grocery store. Now, remember, there's only really two tools that the Federal Reserve has, and I like to call them a screwdriver and a water hose. A screwdriver is the tightening of the cost of borrowing, which is really the only thing that really advertising in today's news, which is interest rates. If interest rates go up, it is like tightening the screw. And it costs more to borrow. There's less profitability in companies, less money to pass through to their employees or their investors. And that is the main tool that we're seeing advertised now. But the one that's not advertised, because it's quite frankly detrimental to the government, is the water hose, which is money supply. And that has been on full blast over the past 2 years. Since the creation of money in the United States, money supply is up 40% in 2 years. It does not take a math person to know if you eat 40% more calories over the last 2 years than you're used to over your lifespan, you're going to have a weight problem. So we're talking tens of trillions of dollars, $8 trillion during the pandemic, $40 billion spent bailing out just three banks that failed in March of 2023. And as formerly mentioned, that doesn't include the full cost of the Inflation Reduction Act, priced at over $1 trillion currently. That's not only our biggest problem. We also have de-dollarization. As the United States continues to mismanage its currency, the rest of the world's like, why should we import your inflation, your inflated money supply? And so they're trading less and less in dollars and actively working to come up with ways to not use the dollar in international trade. If they don't need those dollars anymore, they're going to ship them back to us. And that in and of itself is a water hose of increasing money supply. This has been a long-term agenda of other countries. It's not going to stop or be controlled by our Federal Reserve. Then, of course, we've got this colossal and ever-ratcheting national debt. The government is going to have to print more money just to pay the bills. I don't think inflation is a short-term thing. I think it's something we need to be used to. In the words of Pink Floyd, "Mother, should I trust the government?" You make your own decision. Or as my dad said, you cannot trust the fox to watch the hen house. You can't have the same government that is controlling money supply telling you what the real inflation is. We need third-party checks and balances like the sites that I've mentioned above. What can you do about it? I think first and foremost, educate and do research if you're a DIYer on how to invest or work with a qualified professional. This is not investment advice or securities advice. I'm just saying your dollars are losing purchasing power and the only real choice you have is a way to help those dollars try to grow back some of the losses. All investing costs, you know, has risk and pros and cons. Again, just a general education statement. You've got to try to fight the tide. Another quote from the song from John Mayer, when they own the information, they can bend it all they want. So another thing you can do to help change is consider where you're getting your news media. And if it's mainstream, it may have a lot of themes that are unified towards keeping you believing what they want you to believe versus doing your own research or watching independent channels, of course. I appreciate the comments, subscribes, and likes. It really helps us out. Lastly, ask yourself, do you want bigger governments, more departments, more divisions to report to, and more money to spend complying with more regulations? Or do you want more more freedom and sound money? That's for you to decide as we continue to vote in our free system. Hope you enjoyed this. Y'all take care.